So a heart attack is an acute reduction to the blood flow, to the heart muscle, and that usually presents with a variety of different symptoms. The classic way of describing a pain related to the heart attack or the symptoms related to the heart attack is chest tightness or pressure. People oftentimes describe it as an elephant sitting on my chest. In practice, we actually see a whole different variety of different symptoms that people come in with, and we end up finding that there is a heart attack that is happening. My name is Sadeer Al-Kindi. I'm a cardiologist. I specialize in prevention of cardiovascular disease and imaging of cardiovascular disease. Traditionally, the way that we thought about this is that men are more likely to present with what we call typical symptoms, and this is chest tightness in the middle of the chest, going to the left arm or the left shoulder, and going to the jaw as well, and associated with sweating. So this is what we call the classical chest pain. It turns out, at least anecdotally and in some studies, that women may present with more what we call atypical symptoms. You know, we're still calling them chest pain, some chest tightness, but sometimes nausea can be a cause, sometimes palpitations, sometimes other types of chest pain. And we consider those to be, you know, atypical. We take it seriously because we know that there are a lot of different symptoms that people can present with that may indicate a heart attack. And there are, in reality, there's a lot of overlap between them because panic attacks can present with palpitations, heart beating fast. It can present with sweating. It can present with chest tightness and chest pain. And these symptoms can be, you know, very much indicative of a heart attack as well. And it's all have to be taken seriously and has to be, you know, evaluated by a medical professional. They have to be, there are tests that we can do, including tests regarding the heart health. We do, and it depends all on the scenario. And that's why, you know, medicine is complex, because we have to think about each and every one of these symptoms to understand what is the probability that this is actually a heart problem versus a panic attack versus other causes, including lung disease. But I think there is no harm in going to the doctor. For the most part, there's no harm in going to the doctor to evaluate this, because sometimes symptoms that are seemingly not dangerous or not alarming can actually indicate a more severe problem, and vice versa. Sometimes symptoms can be really alarming and they don't indicate anything related to the heart or anything serious that's going on organically. So I think it's always good to get chest pains evaluated, given the spectrum of things, dangerous things or serious things that can be indicative of.